Hi friends, welcome back to the new series JavaScript 0 to Hero. In this series, I'm explaining all the basic concepts in JavaScript. In this video, I'm going to talk about date object in JavaScript. We can create a date in JavaScript using a new date constructor. There are different ways we can create a date. When we create a date using empty constructor, we get the current date and time. If you want to create a specific date, we can pass a valid date string inside the constructor. We can give it like this. Or we can also give it like this. It should be a valid date string. You can see when I give in DDMMYYYY format, it is giving me invalid date. In the meantime, MMDDYYYY is considered as valid. Instead of passing a string, we can also pass it like this. Here the first parameter is year, second one is month, third one is day, fourth one is hour, fifth one is minute, sixth one is second, and the last one is millisecond. One thing to note here is JavaScript counts month from 0 to 1. So January is 0, February is 1, and so on. Here except year and month, other parameters are optional. When we are not specifying those optional parameters, it will be defaulted. Here you can see the date is defaulted to 1 and the time values are defaulted to zeros. I told year and month parameters are mandatory. But when we ignore one of them and give only one parameter, it won't throw error. Because in JavaScript, we can also create a date using milliseconds. When we create a date, JavaScript stores dates as number of milliseconds since this date. So when I create a date by passing 0, we can see this date. And if I pass 8640000, which is the number of milliseconds in a day, we can see the next day, Jan 2, 1970. So when we pass only one parameter, that will be considered as milliseconds. There are many inbuilt functions available to process the date. Let me create a new date. Now I can get the year using the function getFullYear. Similarly, I can also get the month using getMonth. Date using getDate. Hours using getHours. Minutes using getMinutes. Seconds using getSeconds. And milliseconds using getMilliseconds. You can see getMilliseconds gives the milliseconds part of the current time. But if you want to get the total milliseconds since January 1, 1970, you can use the getTime function. You can also use the getDay function to get the current day. Here also it starts from 0. So 0 means Sunday, 1 means Monday, and so on. Like how we use the get methods to get the date information, we can also use the respective set methods to modify the date. Let me show an example. I have created a new date, so you can see this. Now I can change the year using setFullYear function, like this. So you can see the date has changed now. Similarly, you can use the other set methods. That's all about date object. If you like this video, please subscribe and support me. I'll be back with another concept soon. Thank you. Bye.